What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today we're going to overview Synder. This one is going to make your e-commerce accounting a breeze. Now, what it does is that it's going to integrate your payment accounts like PayPal, Stripe, Square, and your accounting systems like QuickBooks, like Xero, and your bank account, and they're going to talk to each other via this app. Now, we know that, for example, Stripe doesn't talk to PayPal, and we don't know what's happening in one or the other because they don't talk to each other. We have to manually input the information, or if we want to quickly search for a payment information on one of those platforms, well, we have to go over to the platform, go to the right section, search, and use filters and all of that. In Synder, we can do this really quickly because it syncs. Now, all we have to do is just make a click and it'll take us to PayPal, Stripe, QuickBooks, or Xero, whatever you're using, and it's gonna take us to that right spot. Plus, we can also create invoices and quick payment links with Synder. So there's a lot to talk about and a lot to cover on this video. So let's go jump over to Synder right now. Okay, this is the Synder site, and I recommend you jump over there. That link will be provided in the description. The reason I want you to jump here is because I want you to go to integrations, and you're going to see how powerful this actually is, because this is where you're going to know if this is the right fit for you, if it has the companies that you need. So for example, we can see all the integrations. For example, we have Shopify, Stripe, Etsy, Amazon, Square, PayPal, BigCommerce, WooCommerce, which is really popular, and some other ones that are not so popular, but you might need them. Well, actually Wix is super popular, but yeah, check these out if that's something that it's the right fit for you. Plus, we have the connections to bank account. For example, in this case, we have Chase, Bank of America, Wells Fargo, practically all the big companies are right here. And yes, Wise is actually available here. So we have Wise.com available, which was previously known as TransferWise, which is a really popular platform for banking. So yes, it does integrate with it, and you can get the information from there. Okay, here's our Synder dashboard. Now, before we jump into this information right here, the first thing I recommend is that you head on over to settings. So let's go over there first. And the reason I recommend this is that once you connect your accounts in the beginning, we have a little bit more of setup to do to fine tune it, all right? So for example, the general settings, organization name, we can update it if we made a mistake in the beginning. We can set our time zone if we want to change that. In this case, I'm in the trial plan. So everything that you're seeing right now, it's on the trial plan. The accounting company that I'm using Synder in this case. The payment platforms, I have connected two Stripe accounts and my PayPal account. I can add more payment platforms right here by choosing them and connecting to them. It's super easy to integrate. All you have to do is just log in and allow the access. It'll tell you what you're going to allow and disallow there, and you said yes or no, all right? Once you connect, you'll see this, and I recommend that you jump into configure for these accounts. So once we jump in here, we have several options available. For example, do you want to synchronize automatically ongoing transactions? For obvious reasons, keep it on unless you want to do it manually, but and like I said, keep it on. Do you want to skip synchronization of duplicate transactions? Again, I recommend that you leave it on because you don't want to have two transactions that are duplicates and things could get really messy. So keep it on. For sales, we can do some information here. For example, the bank account that this is tied to, in this case, Stripe bank account, but we can choose another one if we want to switch it to checking, PayPal bank account, or unauthorized assets. Next thing we have is product and services. If we want to map these differently, for now it's default product, Stripe product, but we can map these if they are not mapped already, okay? The taxes, do you want to add the taxes right here? So sales tax settings, do we want to turn it on? And obviously fill in the data, expense tax settings, the fees, the application fees, the payouts, and we have additional settings available right here. For example, adjustments, application fees, application refunds, and all of that. So like I said before, check these with Calm. There's a ton of tutorial videos available from Synder. So check those out with Calm and fill out the information that you need in the beginning. Okay, let's go back into our transactions. Let's leave here. Okay, and here's the transactions from my recent payments. Now, like I said before, I connected this and I got the recent payments. Now, if we want to grab the previous payments, I recommend that you head on over to import historical data. Once you are there, you can select the date range that you want to import the data. Let's just say that, you know what, I started my Stripe account 6 months ago and I only got the recent information because I just connected. Well, I need to import that data if I want to have it here. If not, well, just don't do it. But I recommend you import your history data so you have the all the information available. Okay, so these are some recent payments that I have. We have the information here from who, the transaction ID, the type, the amount, the payment platform that was used. For example, we have Stripe and PayPal because I connected those two. The date, the sync status, and the action. Now you'll see that some of them are synced and some of them are not. That's because some I did sync manually and I can select all and just go ahead and sync them. But in this case, I just synced some. Now what happens with synced? Well, it grabs information. Let's go show some details here. Okay, so we have the sync ID, the Stripe company that's connected to, VME Media, Synder company, SAS Master, status, this one is synced, the sync date finish, the amount, the date, and the ID. Now on the bottom, we have the sync log, okay? So we have the information. So this one is tied to an invoice that was paid on my invoicing platform. So it grabbed that information and I have it right here. I can go see all this information, for example, for products that were paid, showed here. And here are other products that were paid recently, okay? So for example, I can edit or delete these or create a new one manually. That was synced automatically. So like I said before, the beauty about this is that it's going to grab the information from Stripe, PayPal, if you have a Square, well, Square, and Amazon and all of those integrations and bring them inside of here. This is gonna make your e-commerce accounting a breeze, like I said before. Plus, it's gonna automatically deduct the fees that they are charging you. Why is this important? Because let's just say that you charge $1,000. Well, it doesn't mean that you won $1,000 because Stripe, PayPal has like a small fee and commission. Well, you gotta deduct that. So it's not like you got $1,000. You got $998 and not exactly $1,000. So this helps you have all that information available. Let's go back into the transactions. Let's go back to banking. Okay, and in this case, I have the banking information here. We have the Synder transactions. We said about the importing the historical data, select the platform, and we select the date range that we want to import. Now, this one is a really cool feature, smart rules. This is an automation feature. Now, the cool part about this is that they have templates. So you don't have to do some guesswork and think how, what can I do with this? What should I connect? Well, there's a bunch of connections already or templates that you could just integrate easily and quickly with a few steps. Like I mentioned before, there's a lot of tutorials on Synder's YouTube channel. I will leave that link in the description because it helps you get started really quickly. So for example, you can add an automation like thank you email for invoice payments. And this will send an email to customers when a payment is applied automatically, all right, by using this automation. And there's several automations for categorization, classes, invoicings, location, marketing, reminder, taxes for non-US, taxes for UK, and taxes for US. This helps you automate. Now, what is automation in a nutshell? Well, what it does is that it uses conditional logic. So if something happens from your transactions, like from Stripe, PayPal, Square, and all of those, if something happens, then we're gonna tell it to do this, all right? So if this happens, do that. That's the conditional logic we have right here. Now, unfortunately, I don't have connected my QuickBooks, but if I did, I would be able to use the smart rules. But like I said, there's a lot of videos on Synder channel. For sales, we have invoicing. Okay, let's go here. Let's create a quick invoice right here. Now, you don't have to go to Stripe to do this or PayPal or any one of those. We can do it from right here. Let's set an invoice number. Let's just say 123. The customer, we'll use one of the customers that we have already. If not, we'll have to import one of them. And we'll just say diarrhea. Sorry, I don't know how to say that. The creation date, the due date. So we can say, hey, you know what? You have one day to pay this. That we do. We want to browse some files. SAS Master, okay. My logo's there. Okay, so we got the customer, the due date. We can change the customer. The billing address, the location. So for example, we can add a location, edit address if we need to. The currency that we can choose from. And by the way, this is multi-currency. The add tax if we like. The product and services, we can say one of the services that we have. For example, just like that. It grabbed these services from my payment gateway. But we can create this. So this just says testing. The price for this, $100. And we can add a line if we want. The subtotal, we can add a discount. The shipping price, customer memo, like non-refundable, we can say that there. And if we're good to go, we can set the settings. Yes, I want to accept credit cards for this account, done. Do we want to make this recurring? So if we want to make it recurring, we can do it like that. Infinite or how many recurring payments? So for example, if you made a contract for 1 year, well, we make that monthly and we'll set remaining for 12 times, all right? So that would be a contract for 12. We can cancel that, we can set it automatically. And we also have the email templates that we can send. So if we're good to go, we can save and send. Okay, so do we wanna send this invoice by email? We have the email already because we captured it from the last time they made a payment. And if we don't, we'll create a shareable link. Okay, got it marked as sent. Here's our link. Well, let's just copy it there, done. Let's open an incognito mode because I want you to view how this is, how the customer is actually going to view it. I'm not logged in, and here's the invoice for $100 to view the invoice, and they can pay really quickly by adding their credit card details and just pay right away. If they want to view the invoice, like, hey, what's this about? Okay, so it's invoice for this, and it's $100, okay? Customer memo, non-refundable. All right, so we got that there really easily and quickly. So that's one of the ways that you can create invoices really quickly. Now, one of the cool things about this is that you also have payment links. These are pretty neat because you could just send out a link, create it really quickly, and go send it out. I already created one and I named it Pay Me Now. And you set up the settings and we have a direct link and a payment button. So if you want to embed this on your website, well, just copy this code and embed it over there. If not, grab the link, send it to someone, and let's just go ahead and open it, okay? Here's a link I'm sending to anyone. And the link I created, it's not for a fixed amount. The link I created is set so that they can put any amount that they want to pay. So for example, I already told them that they need to pay me $45, all right? So they'll put it there, credit card details, and make the payment. So they can put the amount that they want. If I want to put a fixed amount, let's go back, create a new payment link. And in this case, we'll just say test, description, test. If we want to add the logo, okay, the payment options, and this is a fixed amount or an open amount. The preview that you just saw, it's an open amount. But if I wanted to make it a fixed, if I know if it's going to be $45 every single time, we can do that there. Add customer notes, allow. Can they put customer notes or do we want the address also? Let's create this link. We'll keep it on. And this is a test link. Again, we'll copy this one and we're going to open it. This one is a fixed amount. So now we have the logo, more information provided by, and in this case, we enabled the address. So you have those type of two links that we could just send out really quickly and get payments. And that's a link that you can embed on your site. You can just send it out or keep it on your bio link, or just if you wanna receive donations, just however you want to use it, you got that available really quickly. We have our sales receipts right here. So for example, we have a recent payment from these right there, and we have the total for them. We have our contacts. These are automatically synced from the payments that we received. I didn't add these, but yes, we can add our own right here. Okay, let's close this. Products and services. Again, these are synced from the platforms that we have already, from the payments that we received. But if not, we can create more products here so we can use these on our invoice to create them really quickly and already set what we want for the invoice. We have our expenses, and you'll see that we have deductions right here from the payments that we received. So from the vendor, Stripe and PayPal, these are the deductions that we got, all right? So like I said before, if you got a payment for $1,000 or $500 or whatever, it doesn't mean that you won $1,000 or $500 because we have expenses that we need to look out for. In this case, we have these expenses that were made automatically from these payment platforms and they're deducted automatically. Next thing we have is reporting for sales. Okay, we have the quick chart right here. We can zoom in, zoom out, and we can move these around or we can export them on XML. File for spreadsheets. We can select the companies, we got our filters, the currency, in this case it's only USD, but we get more options if we have more. Select the intervals, for example, this month to date, last month, or a custom interval for this. Compared to a previous period, so we have two in case we want to compare these. We have our expenses reporting also, so again, we can view this, and we have our filters on the right. Profit and loss, okay. Here's our profit and here's our expenses. Here is where we have an overview of the date range that we have available that we selected here. We have our profits and loss. Like I said before, it doesn't mean that you won 1,000. There are expenses to consider there. And this is an overview of that. So we have the income, the sales, here's the total. And then we also have expenses for that that gives us a total of this right here. So we have a quick overview. And also we have the balance sheet. This is where we have obviously the balance for our bank, for our checking account, for our Stripe account, for PayPal account. And we have a balance of what we have right now available. And we have the total for this, plus the total assets, liability, the equities, and the total equities right here, $4,012 from the balance sheet. Next, we have the chart of accounts. This is a chart of all the accounts that are connected. What we have is the name of the account, the type, the subtype, and the balance that we have on these accounts. And we have all that information available right here because we connected with them. And last but not least, we have the payroll. This one, you can sign up for the demo, check it out if it's something that you need. It will do automated taxes, insurance and benefits, made for mobile, and detailed payroll books. So you can do all your payroll right here also. So basically, that is what Synder does. It's an e-commerce accounting system, so you can do everything really easily and quickly right here and not have to go into every single account and individually do everything manually or go into QuickBooks and Zero and just do everything manually. Do this here, save time, and obviously save money by saving time. Well, I thank you all for watching. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.